Review, so close up those Chromebooks unless you are Riley. Everybody else needs to close their Chromebook all the way closed so it clicks closed. I'm waiting to hear the clicks. I know, you might be behind, but you don't want to miss today or you'd be further behind.
I need to retake show you something.
I'll give you a chance to do some work today, though. How's that? Okay, but you're not going to get the whole period. So close them up, close them up. Right, so quick review here. We've got these factoring patterns. You've got to know these. The first thing you should do, if you haven't done this assignment, and I think I had it messed up so I accidentally put a close date on it, didn't mean to. Go to the one that says factoring pattern memorization. And all it is just you filling in the blanks on these to get some practice memorizing them. And it's not hard. And you can, going through that assignment once, you'll have all those memorized, if you don't already. Okay, but let's quickly review. What are these patterns? So the difference of squares pattern. If I have a squared minus b squared, how does that always factor?
Minus b
times
a plus e.
Good. And I don't care the order. It makes no difference, right? You can do a plus b times a minus b, and that's just as correct. Okay, what about the next one? This is, and I'll give you a hint, this is a trick.
A squared plus b squared.
Doesn't factor. There is no pattern. So in other words, if I tell you to factor this completely, if you have something like x squared plus 4, okay, listen please. If I have x squared plus 4, John, let's close that up. Actually, you might be a different boat, because we talked, you're fine. X squared plus 4, then you can't think, okay, that's x squared plus 4 squared, plus 2 squared, it doesn't factor, it doesn't matter. Even if it did work out to be a squared plus b squared, there's no pattern. It does not factor, okay? Difference of squares does. And then the two that are probably the most important, the sum of cubes and the difference of cubes. Remember, those factored into a small factor and a big factor. What was the small factor for sum of cubes?
A plus
b times?
Minus
ab plus b squared. And remember what we saw for the pattern on this, right? The pattern was, first of all, you know that you're just going to get the small factor, the two terms are just a and b. In the big factor, you get three terms, a squared, ab, and b squared, right? And then look at the way the signs work with this. Whatever sign you start with is the sign that goes in the small factor. You're going to alternate signs the next time, so you're going to do the opposite, right? And then the last one is always plus, right? So what are we going to get here, Carlos? What are we going to get for a difference of cubes then?
A minus b.
And then it drops.
B.
A squared.
And then it's
plus a b.
Plus.
B squared, right?
Yes.
Okay. So close that up. Okay, so then how about something like that? Now, I want to just show you one other important point here. You can take shortcuts sometimes, and do when you can. That's a good thing. So if I'm trying to answer this question, find the real solutions of this binomial equation, polynomial with two terms is binomial, right? What could I do? I don't have to do anything fancy. Add 27 and divide by 8, and then what?
Cube root.
Because if I want the real solutions, even if it's cubic, I can just isolate x, right? So if I add 27, divide by 8, and then if I cube root both sides, what am I going to get for my answer? What's the cube root of 27?
3.
Cube root of 8. And remember, there's no plus or minus with a cube root, right? So I can get the one real solution very quickly that way, right? But if we are asked to find all complex solutions, including solutions with eyes, we didn't get them. They're still hidden, right? Remember from, you know, last week when we talked just a little bit about third-degree polynomial equations. The degree of the polynomial tells you how many complex solutions you're going to get. We're going to get three complex solutions here, but it turns out only one of them is real. The other two are going to be imaginary, and the imaginary ones are always packaged in pairs, complex conjugate pairs. So you can think of them as plus or minus pairs, right? So how are we going to get these then? Well, I suppose we talked about the patterns. How are we going to solve this equation? This must be, we have to use the pattern then, right? If we want to get all the solutions, we have to use our factoring pattern. Now, what's the only factoring pattern that could possibly work here?
A minus B.
Not A minus B.
What is it that, oh, A minus B.
Which one?
Yeah.
A cubed
minus B.
Minus B cubed. So the difference of cubes, and we can see that because I've got something cubed minus something, right? So the only one that could work is difference of cubes, right? So then if we, can we write this as A cubed minus B cubed? Because if we can, we can follow the pattern. Okay, we can in this case. So what do I have to cube to get my first term? 2x, right? Because I've got to have 2 cubed is 8, and x cubed is x cubed, right?
Yep.
What's the second thing that's being cubed here?
3.
3. Because 3 cubed is 27, right? So a is 2x, and b is 27. And now we're just going to follow our pattern, right? We already know the pattern, right? The pattern is, you've already told me, a cubed minus b cubed equals a minus b times
a cubed.
Everybody, you all need to know this.
A
squared plus, you got to alternate, right? Plus a b
plus b squared.
Plus b squared. Good. Okay, so we're going to get a minus b. What's that? What's A?
Wait, what are you doing? 2x or 8x?
It'd
be 2x.
Okay.
It would just be 8x.
So this is the problem that we're solving, right? But does that look like something cubed minus something cubed? Not yet. We have to write it that way. So 8x cubed, to write that as A cubed, we have to write it as something cubed. Well, the something would be a 2x, right? Because 2x times 2x times 2x is 8x cubed. Right? What's the other something? 3, because 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. So this is like, the point I want to make here is that 2x is my A and 3 is my B, but I'm just going to follow the pattern then, right? So good, so we're going to get A minus B. Well, we just said that's 2x minus 3 times, right? Because there's my A and there's my B. A squared. Well, what's A? 2x. So I've got to do 2x squared. What's that?
4x squared.
4 times x squared. Good. Plus a times b. 2x times 3. What's that?
6x.
Plus b, which is 3 squared, which is 9. Yeah. And that whole thing is equal to 0, right? So now what do we do? Now this is just a little different version of stuff that we've done for a long time. When we're trying to solve an equation by factoring, the reason we factor is so we can use the zero product property, right? Now we've got, instead of this one big equation, we've got these two smaller factors. Smaller in the sense that one of them is linear and one of them is quadratic, right? And so if we set those equal to zero, we can easily solve to get our solution. So the first one is going to be, if I set this factor equal to 0, what am I going to get? What are the two steps in order I'm going to do to solve for x? So what's that going to give me?
3 over 2.
Good.
hey, what do you know? That's what we got before. There's our real solution, right? Now, what about this guy here? So this one, we don't know yet, but whatever this quadratic factor is, we're going to set it equal to 0. I want to remind you about something from the other day, something that I mentioned, I'm going to mention again. Both of those, if we use either of the sum or difference of cubes patterns, the quadratic that we get at the end, we call an irreducible quadratic factor. It's irreducible means I can't break it down anymore. It's not going to factor. Caleb, put that away, please. So it's not going to factor. The other thing we need to know about this is they will always give me imaginary solutions. I'm never going to get real solutions out of those, right? So all we have to do then is once we get that irreducible quadratic factor, we will solve by setting it equal to 0. So we get the equation 4x squared plus 6x plus 9 equals 0, right? Now think about this in terms of how we solve quadratic equations, because that's all this is, right? You guys have covered a lot of ground this year, and I feel like you've gotten pretty good at some things that are pretty important. Solving quadratic equations is one of them, right? Think about how you approach solving quadratic equations. That's just a part of this big problem, but that's one that you know how to tackle now. Think about our strategies. Can I point to a single x?
No.
I cannot, so I can't isolate x. Unfortunately, that's easy, right? Do I want to look for magic numbers?
No,
because I've got a 4 in front of the x squared. I don't want to bother. Even if I found them, using magic numbers means bottoms up, and that's too hard. We don't want to mess with all that. So if I can't find magic numbers, I'm not even going to bother with completing the square, because we've decided it's easier to just do what? Quadratic formula. Yeah. If you can't do it really easily, we'll just use quadratic formula, right? So let's apply the quadratic formula here. X equals what? Negative b, but and b is, you guys are already jumping into plugging values in, which is good. A is 4, b is 6, c is 9, right? So we're going to get negative b plus or minus the square root of what? Okay, 6 squared, b squared, right? B squared is 36 minus 4 times
4 times 9 divided by 2
times 4
divided by 2 times 4, which is 8. Good. Okay, so let's simplify this then to get our other solutions. So x equals negative 6 plus or minus. I'm going to go kind of fast. I don't want to hang up on one problem so much. So 36 minus, that's 144, so I'm going to get negative 108. Okay, all divided by 8. What's going to happen here? Because I have a negative inside the radical. What do I know I'm getting? I'm getting an I. So there's no chance that these two terms are going to combine. So I'm going to split the fraction up. Right. So I'm going to get negative 6a's, which we can reduce, plus or minus, we don't know. We're going to simplify the top. Whatever that simplifies to be over 8 times I, right? So what does 108 give us? If we use a factoring tree on 108, what's a number that goes into 108? What?
4.
4 does. 4 is just any, it doesn't matter, just a number that goes in. It's all going to come out the same. So 4 times 27. 4 reduces to what? 2 and 2. What about 27? 9 and 3, 9 goes to 3 and 3. So look what we get then. Square root of 108, I'm going to get a couple of 2's, a couple of 3's, and a single 3. So what's it work out to be?
6 and 3, 3 and 6.
6 radical 3. Good. Okay. So now, last thing we could do here is we could simplify our answers. So we're going to get x equals, what does 6 over 8 become?
3 over 4.
Good. So I get a 3, oops. Negative 3/4 plus or minus. What about over here? Same thing, right? 6 over 8 reduces to 3 over 4. So I get 3 radical 3, right? The square root of 3 stuck there, over 4 times I. Okay, real quick, something I've seen occasionally people doing. if I have something like the square root of 6 over 2, can I reduce that?
No.
I cannot. Sometimes people want to make that the square root of 3. Can't do that. I can only reduce by canceling numbers or reducing numbers outside of the radicals, right? So we couldn't do anything with that. How many solutions are there?
Two.
One for the plus, one for the minus. I got my 3 then, didn't I? My 1 real and my 2 imaginary. Notice that as advertised, they come packaged in a plus or minus pair. The imaginary ones, right? Okay, so that's our quick review of an example of using factoring patterns to solve binomials. Okay, so I'll tell you what I'll do. I know you need a little bit of time. So I'm gonna cut you a little slack today, and I'm gonna let you work for the rest of the period, and then I will try to give you one more work day later in the week. That's the most I can do this week.
When is the test gonna be like on for?
I'll give you all week. Give you all week. Because you guys don't have, you have a short day Wednesday and no school Friday. So I'll give you all week.
Yeah. You don't have school Friday?
No.
Okay.